Hello YouTube, it's time to play some Doom Snap map again. I've got a subscriber recommended map here from Famous1Creation. This is MF Doom Room Must Play. Now that's a signature of Mr. Famous1. I've played a number of his maps at this point, and he's always keen to let you know that this map, along with all of his other maps, are a must play. Because he lets you know right there in the title block. And, you know, on that subject, I might as well talk about kind of my opinion on putting must play at the end of a map title. Or any other kind of thing. Because it actually did come up in the comments a while back. Somebody was asking me about it. Fundamentally, I have no problem with it. If somebody wants to use the title block of their map or the map description to proclaim to people how great their map is and promote it, then go for it. There's nothing wrong with that, certainly. There's nothing ethically wrong. I mean, you can do whatever, right? Now, the question is, should you? I'd say the first question to that is, well, does it work? Does putting must play at the end of your title actually cause more people to play it? My feeling is that, surprisingly, yes, it does. Yeah, it does. I think about, like, you know, think of, like, restaurants and places that, you know, like, oh, yeah, come eat at our pizzeria because we have the best pizza in town or something, or you know, buy these eggs. These eggs are the best eggs that come from the happiest chickens. Or so, you know, people put these kind of just general phrases that they use for advertising. I think it's called puffery is the technical term. But, you know, people put these advertisements in there, and you think that they wouldn't work, but the reason that they do it is because it does cause, you know, if somebody will see this map, and they'll MF Doom Room, and they'll, oh, must play. And for a number of people, that will actually be enough to convince them, that will pique their curiosity enough to actually try playing it. The thing is, though, like, I think if somebody does play it for that reason, they're more likely to be critical of your map. So, you kind of, if you hype it up to that level by saying it's a must play, and if it's only just an average map, I think they're more likely to be critical and downvote it. So if you're gonna be, if you are going to put it out there as being, you know, fantastic, the best, must play, then you really have to, it really has to be the best, right? But personally, I don't recommend that people even bother doing that, to be honest. I mean, you can, but to me, it's, if you have a good map that's really fun, then people will play it and people will promote it regardless of whether or not you put these kind of gimmicks in the title. And if you have a bad map and you say it's a must play, then you're just misleading people. So either it's a good map and you don't need it, or it's a bad map and you shouldn't have it. So there we go. That's my official position on promoting one's map within one's title block. I got no problem with it. It might work. It might get some extra plays. Ultimately, is it gonna do much for your map in the long run? Not really. So, I wouldn't really bother with it too much. So anyway, moving on. MF Doom Room Must Play from Famous1Creation. Map description reads, a total onslaught on demonic trash. Kill demons to unlock exit doors. Also, retrieve the BFG and use traps to survive. Good luck. Okay, let's launch it. Now, I'm playing this map for the very first time. I've never played it before. My reaction is my live reaction. My commentary is my commentary. After the end of completing this map, however it ends, good or bad, I'm going to go ahead and give my final thoughts, talk about just the map generally, talk about what I like the most, what I like the least, give my favorite, my least favorite, and hopefully this will be helpful to the person who recommended it. And, you know, I've been pleasantly surprised by my subscribers as far as, like, you know, they take criticism really well. You know, some people would be like, oh man, you think that there was something wrong with my map? Oh, my map's the best. You know, I mean, you gotta be open to criticism. That's how you improve. And often, you know, I am playing it wrong. You know, there was one map where a guy left a shotgun out for me to grab. I didn't see it. And that was one of my biggest complaints. Like, oh, you didn't put a shotgun in your level. And turns out it was there the whole time. But you know what? Even though I was wrong, still found that to be useful information. So here we go. Starts out like a bullet train. There's definitely no easing you into this one. That's okay though, it doesn't bother me at all. Oh boy. Already tough guys coming out of here. Oh jeez. Oh man. Already a Baron? Wow. That quick press. What? Oh, is that the trap? One of the traps? Oh, rocket launcher. Hell yeah. Huh. I don't know, I feel like these traps are kinda... How should I say this? I feel like the traps are kind of perilous to try to use because you've gotta stand in front of that kiosk and press the button. It almost seems like it's really not worth your time to even try to use them. Doom kills for entry. What was that? Oh, I have to have that many points. 10,000 points. Okay. Yeah, so I can just... If I just shoot with my rocket launcher, that'll basically be the same thing as setting off the trap. Let me make sure I got this right. Yeah. No, wait. Oh! Whoa. Okay, yeah, so that blows up the barrels. Yeah, okay. Okay, I see. Yeah, the traps set off those explosive barrels. Yeah, I don't really see myself using the switches too much. I might use the traps if there's already a guy in there. like that situation. But that's going to be me shooting the barrel, it's not going to be me actually activating the switch. Because that seems kind of perilous, honestly. But, oh shoot, snuck up on me. Or spawned behind me, perhaps. Whoa! Oh, health and armor. What is this? Quick press, another trap. Oh, I don't want to get boxed in. Burst action. I don't really like the burst rifle. Nope, not a big fan of the burst rifle. Oh, that made quick work of him. I got 13 lives, wow. That ain't bad. Oh, is that a chain gun? I'm gonna grab it. No! Ooh, I really need help. Get out of here. No! Wait, where did I get all that extra health? Must have backed into something. As soon as I take one out, it spawns another one. Ooh, a shoddy. Heck yeah. Getting kills from- oh, what's in here? Whoa, no. That was a bad idea to get stuck. Oh, Baron of Hell. Bad idea. I gotta get out of here. Oh, where the heck did he come from? That guy just came jumping out of nowhere. This isn't the same door I already opened, is it? Mm-hmm. Oh. Oh, this guy. Wait, can you not die? Can he die? Looks like the health keeps coming back to me. I'm not entirely sure if that Mancubus will die. It doesn't appear to be, Okay, I got the red power cell. Gotta find something to put it in, though. Hey, what can I do with the red power cell? What do you do with the red power cell? No. Yeah, that guy's not taking damage at all. Oh, maybe I have to kill him with a trap. It doesn't seem like I can even lure him out of his little hallway. He's gonna come after me? No, he's not coming after me at all. Ooh! Red key card. I don't know. I don't even know what to do with this red power cell, to be honest. Let's see if I can use this trap on him. Yep. Did it work? No, he's still there. He didn't run through it. Oh wait! Oh, I can kill him! Oh, sweet. Yeah, still have no... Exactly. But anyway, like I was saying earlier, I've been pleasantly surprised how successful this channel has been as far as providing people with feedback. Everybody's been pretty positive about it so far. Which I was kind of surprised because I always figured there'd be a good chance somebody would see a review and just be real butthurt about it, you just weren't playing it right, and what do you mean that you find a fault somewhere in it, this perfect map of mine? But everybody's been, really open to constructive criticism, and I think it's been and because, it's only what I would want personally as an editor, right? Because what I always wanted was somebody to play my map, and I just want to see what they liked and what they didn't, and that would give me information as far as what I could improve and what was good. And you want to focus on what's good and accentuate that and make that kind of the highlight of your map. Focus on what works, right? And as far as the things that don't work, fix them or get rid of them, right? People seem to be pretty happy with, I've seen a lot of... people seem to be happy with the suggestions, and they've made changes as appropriate. But, I'm not the, my reviews are based on my perception, right? And sometimes my perception is... my perception is just based on my gameplay experience. And... it could very well be that I'm just not playing it right. In which case... say the, referencing the map where I couldn't find the shotgun that was in plain sight... what's the difference between having a shotgun that's in plain sight that I just don't find because I don't notice it versus not having a shotgun at all? I hope you guys know what I'm talking about here, but a particular map where I felt there should have been a shotgun in a certain level and there wasn't. The difference is there's no difference because my perception is all that matters. The player's perception is all that matters. No one's gonna open up your map to double check to see if you legitimately put it in there or not. Anyway, my point is, it was pretty funny what happened afterwards, because the guy just, I could tell, he updated his map, he just moved this basket that had the shotguns in it closer to the other weapons so that people like me just wouldn't overlook it. So just little things like that are kind of funny. Yeah, so far this map's been a lot of running around, and I don't know, it's getting kind of repetitive at this point, honestly. If I can be so blunt as to say, I've been in this little room quite a while, fighting the same monsters. I wonder what I get for getting, when I get to that 10,000 point mark. Is it just another module? Oh, snap. I'm almost there. I'm almost at 10,000. Almost. Whoops. Alright. This guy's gonna put me there. Bam! Oh wow, 10,000 even. Oh. Oh boy. Oh, here we go. You survived! Yay, I survived. I'm gonna vote it down. Yep. Gotta do it. Alright. Okay, so that was MF Doom Room Must Play by Famous One Creation. I gotta say, you know, I wasn't really impressed by this map. Yeah, I mean, so basically you're in this one module, and it's not even really that big of a module, and there's imps, hell barons, imps, hell knights, and baron of hell. I think there's just those three that run around at you regularly, and if you open, and soldiers, and if you open a door with your points, you get maybe some other demons. But basically, as you kill these demons, you earn points, you accumulate enough points, you can spend them to open a door, which gives you a power up and some more demons to fight, but it's like a little room. I guess the goal is to just get enough points to open to, you gotta get the red power cell, open up the room with the red power cell receptacle, put the red cell into the receptacle, and then that opens the door that takes you to beat the level. And it's basically just a whole bunch of running around in circles and racking up points, and there are these traps, which are basically like a bunch of explosive barrels that you can either shoot or you can punch the button switch, and that sets off the barrels. And I guess you're supposed to use that to thwart your enemies if they're in a position where they can be affected by those barrel traps. You can set them off, and that can disrupt, you know, that can kill your demon enemies if they're there. Yeah, I mean, you know, it's not the worst map I've ever played, but it's got some problems. And honestly, I'm kind of surprised that this author would recommend it to me. After playing his last map, which was, I believe it was called Castle Casters, if I'm not mistaken. And his previous maps to that were all, really on a much higher quality than this. This almost seems like the first map he might have made type of thing. Yeah, just, total. Yeah, definitely not on the same level, I gotta say. I'm gonna get into my favorite and least favorite part about this map. My favorite part about this map. Oh golly, I'm gonna need a minute on that. Let me start out with my least. Let me start out with my least favorite part. And I'll get back to my favorite part when it comes to me. So my least favorite part, I think. My least favorite part had to be the traps, honestly. Because I think the point of this map was supposed to be centered around you have to survive by using these traps to kill the enemies. But the whole thing was, using these switches, the timing is so. What can I say? You're rarely going to be in a situation where it makes sense to stand in front of a switch, hit the switch, and that enemy will happen to be right in that sweet spot where those barrels happen to be. More than likely, you're going to get hit trying to do that. They're going to, you got the Baron of Hell, the Hell Knights, and Imps. You're gonna get wrecked if you try to stop in the middle of the aisleway, hit a switch while they're literally standing 10 feet away from you. It just doesn't seem like a well thought out idea, honestly. I would have liked to have seen these traps set up in a different way where they just weren't so awkward to use, I felt like the best way to use these traps was what I ended up doing, which is just shooting at the barrels. But if you're gonna do that, then why even bother having the switches? So just kind of like the whole thing that this map would have been centered around was the whole idea of this map was you use the traps to fight the demons, but the traps kind of weren't well thought out. Yeah, I don't know. It just seemed like a missed opportunity as far as the traps. I don't know. The execution was just kind of weird. But I also thought it was really unbalanced also as far as the amount of lives you get. Like, I got like 13 lives to complete this level, and I only died once. And I'm not a beginner. I've been playing first-person shooters a long time. I've been playing Doom for about a year, maybe now, and I know what I'm doing basically. I wouldn't call myself an expert. I'm not gonna be winning any Doom competitions anytime soon, but I'm an advanced player, but I only died once, and I got 13 lives. I mean, that's not. The diff it's way too easy. It's way too easy, but at the same time, there's also a lot of running around. A lot of running around for a long period of time in the same exact module. This might have been funner if there were more modules and different types of traps in different areas, and I don't know. I mean, I don't. The concept of setting up traps and killing demons with traps, it actually might have been funner if there were fewer demons and more traps and different modules if you had no weapons at all. That actually would have been kind of interesting. That would have been more of like a survival type thing. Like all you can do to fight the enemies is to set traps. Like there's no weapons at all. That would actually be, if you pulled it off, if you really thought out kind of how to lay out the levels and what kind of traps there would be, that could actually be really interesting. But this was really not that. This was you being stuck in a module for a while, fighting kind of the same enemies with traps that basically amounted to just a bunch of barrels lined up. This map was just very underwhelming. Yeah. Wasn't particularly fun. I got bored kind of halfway through. I gotta be honest about that. A lot. There's just not a lot positive to say about it, really. I mean, I wish there was. I wish there was. I don't play these maps with, looking to be critical, but I'm having a hard time thinking of any redeeming quality here. Oh, golly. Yeah. I like that there was a double barrel shotgun. I don't know. I'm really reaching here. There wasn't really that much I enjoyed about it. I think the best thing was the basic concept, if it could have been realized in a better way. The idea of surviving by using traps to kill demons is a good idea if it was executed properly. Could potentially be a very fun map. This was not that map. I wish I could say it was. Didn't really enjoy it. I don't know. This seems like one of those maps that it would almost be in the abandoned map category. But I think it is there is a glimmer of hope somewhere there. I think if this person were to take the basic concept of using traps to survive, really build a brand new map from the ground up with that concept in mind, and make it so that the map was centered around that, you had no weapons, you gotta survive, you gotta maybe scavenge for resources or so, I don't know. But if you made that the central focus, that could be a winning idea. But this was not that map. Anyway, that's MF Doom Room, must play. And I gotta say, the must play is not deserved for this map. This author I know has made other maps that are good, but not this map. So, I gotta be honest when I gotta be honest, not this map. So anyway, MF Doom Room, Famous One Creation. Ay. I don't know. Anyway, if you guys have a map you'd like to recommend, go ahead and recommend it in the comments. I promise I'll play it and give you a fair and honest review. Whether it's good or bad, that depends on the map. But go ahead, leave a map for me. I promise I'll review it. And until next time, peace out.